You just have bottles over there. Too many bottles.
Wait, what did you call Meret? Puro.
Meret?
What, you remember it's what you called
him? Oh, he had the diaper. The diaper finger. Whatever.
No, it's what you said.
He called him
ass finger. Ass butter.
You wish.
Butter ass.
Butter ass. You wish you had Meret.
His ball. The ball went under his ass. So instead of butter finger, it's butter ass.
Damn, what a week, huh, boy? Look at you dancing with your little shoulders.
Give me a little dance. Give me a little dance to start it.
What's that called? Napoletano?
That's called the Elmas. What's
that called? That's called the cheap loser's dance.
Oh, shit.
Cheap loser.
And we knew they were
going to. All right, can you start? One, two, three, let's go.
What is up, everybody? And welcome back to the Serie Audio Experience with IFTV. Another very, very interesting weekend. We got Ludo over here, who's the only one at the table that won today. So congratulations.
And he just decided to come because they won. I don't know how they win, but let's go.
I always show up. Regardless.
Oh, boy.
We got really lucky, though. Peter, Anto, me and you got really lucky because we're the two losers over here. And we got lucky that Peter's not feeling good, so he's not here today.
We're not afraid of Peter. Forget about
Anto's
Peter.
Usually on the losing side, yeah, so Marco's true. Joining him, which he doesn't join that much.
He's on the winning side, right, Mike?
Yeah. It feels so good, though. I'm never sad or, you know,
but even,
I'm depressed.
Even in the last game, you were flipping against Manolas, too. That's because there's
a Greek on both teams, so I was like kind of torn in the middle, you know?
He plays the field a little bit, you know? When it was going to go for a tie, he's like, yeah, Sassuolo, then Napoli wins, and he's like, you know.
It's Switzerland. It's neutral.
It's neutral, right?
Funny story. The first time Antonio met Mike, he thought he was Swiss.
Yeah.
So maybe you had do you remember that?
I don't remember.
We were in the car.
Remember, Matt said, guess what he is. You're never going to guess. And you said, oh, you're Swiss.
Your dad said that.
Oh, my dad said that?
We're in a car coming back.
Aviator. Yeah. We were playing soccer.
Oh, yeah? Oh,
yeah.
Boy.
Yeah, so maybe you knew all
I must
along.
Have been drunk.
I'm like Ricardo Rodriguez, right? Double R.
You're wearing the colors of him, too. Yeah. Guys, where are we starting today?
From the most important game of the week.
Which
Napoli?
Is?
No.
Oh,
absolutely
okay.
Not. That's not the most important. Juventus. Napoli was the last game of 2019.
Let's start with Napoli, though.
Let's start with Juventus.
It's the most fresh on our mind, I think. We got to give you credit. Yeah. We never really start with Napoli. Now we got to start with Napoli for Ludovico.
You sure?
Yeah.
Let's
sure.
Then we're going to get comments that why are we starting from Naples?
No, why? What's wrong with that?
So we're going to start from Napoli?
Yeah, we'll start from Napoli.
Why not?
We're ready?
We get comments no matter what.
Listen, guys. Don't mind him. It's all choked up because he thought he was never going to win another game.
So are we starting from Napoli or no?
Yes.
May I?
Yes.
Yeah! Oh, I had to let it out.
We had no clue that was coming.
Yeah. I had to let
that
it out.
Amazing.
How's it feel? Nine games now winning.
No, eight
games now winning for Napoli.
It's like not having sex for 2 months.
Oh. Yeah, we can keep this, right? Yeah,
we can keep it.
Yeah, but wait a moment. Ludo, let me ask you something. I mean, you're in front of me, unfortunately, right now.
Why? Unfortunately.
Why Ancelotti leaves, you know, an hour later, he's already the coach of another player. I mean, on another team. Come on.
Well, that sounded a little bit fishy to me also, that someone is let go, and then within 24 hours, you already have a team that's ready to hire you. Remember, in today's world where soccer is mostly a business, 90% is a business, everybody knows what's happening in every nation, in every championship.
I'm sure De Laurentiis knew. Right.
But who's
Napoli
salary?
Napoli doesn't have to pay him anything now.
You sure?
Yes. Napoli's not paying anything.
When you get sacked in football, the team still has to pay you until the rest
until
of your contract.
Until you find another job.
But
until,
if you find another job and you get another team, they don't have to pay you
this
anymore.
Could be an agreement, a mutual agreement between Ancelotti and De Laurentiis. Yes. Listen, I'm going to sack you,
but I got
then you pick up Everton.
Correct.
I think that
because technically speaking, De Laurentiis could have said no.
Yeah,
you're a Napoli employee and you're staying until the end of your contract.
But that would have been stupid for him to do.
I'm just saying.
Yeah,
technically,
yeah.
It could have been. You're an employee of Napoli. Napoli's paying your salary. You stay until the end of your contract. If the president, if the owner,
it never
wants
made. To. Still though, Everton's 16th place.
Were you surprised by that move? Because I think
I'm
we were all
surprised.
I'm
very
surprised.
They're 16th place. I feel like there's a chip on Ancelotti's shoulder where
it's
a lot of the media
Napoli
have said, oh, he can't do it with we've said Ancelotti can only do it with great World players, with champions. Players. Yeah. I feel like there's a chip on his shoulder where he says, I'm going to go to Everton, I'm going to go with these players, and I'm going to show you guys what
son,
I can do.
His son will not be his assistant.
Will not?
Will not.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that was a problem.
Will not be. I think it was a problem also in Napoli.
How do you guys feel about him going to Everton, though? I didn't want to start here, but we're here.
Listen,
so.
I guess Ancelotti wanted out over there. And then since he probably had a good relationship with De Laurenti, said, okay, listen, this is the solution. I'm going.
Yeah,
I'm
but
going
why Everton?
Because he didn't want to just burden them with them paying the salary and hire another coach, probably.
Well, Everton gave him a 4.5-year deal. And I believe it's double the money that he was getting in Napoli. So it's a game plan. It's something to plan for the next
four and a half years
that his plan is to take Everton back
on top
into Europe. Yeah.
They have good players.
Now, whether it's
don't
Champions League or
players.
Europa League, we don't know yet. Mm. But basically, Everton to compete in Europe. That's his plan. That's why he received 4.5 years. Mm. So now he will take these next 6 months to evaluate the team, who needs to be sold and who needs to be purchased. But the money is pretty...
Very good.
At least for Moise Keane, who we know, you know, he had that whole problem. Did you know that he got subbed in and 18 minutes later they subbed him out? Did you hear about that story?
Oh,
the
God.
Interim coach that was the coach right now. And he said it was a technical reason, that it wasn't against his attitude or anything. But hopefully for Moise Keane, Ancelotti going there will be good. We'll still support him. But I was just surprised where there was links.
Correct. It sounds a little bit fishy.
Arsenal, which again, even Arsenal would have made a lot more sense, or some of these other clubs, but... best of luck to him. And anyway, Napoli, you won in the 94th minute, I believe. 93rd minute.
Almost 94th, yeah.
Almost 94th
with
minute.
Elmas.
Elmas got the touch, and Napoli were able to put it away. I think Sassuolo played a really good first half. In the first half, they could have even doubled their lead,
and then Napoli
built into the match.
If I would have to analyze this game to be a movie, I would say first half, a horror show. Second half, romantic.
You're always so good with your analogy.
That would be my analysis. Well, first half, it was a horror show.
Yeah.
That game, the first half, reminded me of the game when we lost the Scudetto in Fiorentina, 3-0, when Koulibaly got thrown out, and the day before, Juventus beat Inter the last minute.
Come back.
And Napoli, psychologically, did not even enter the field against Fiorentina, and they were coming down 3-1, 3-2. And they scored 2-3 goals within 20 minutes. So the first half, it was a horror show.
Some of the players were not even running.
No, Fabian Ruiz should have been taken out at the end of the first half, or at least...
He didn't look very happy when he took him out.
Yeah, he wasn't happy either.
He played a horror show. Well, the change that he made this week, Gattuso, was he put Alan more...
Center.
Over forward midfield, attacking the space, and Fabian Ruiz a little bit... behind.
Mm-hmm.
Then the second half, things switched. When Fabian Ruiz came out and Elvis came in, then Allen went a little bit back.
Mm-hmm.
Then what also kept a little bit of balance was Di Lorenzo coming in the second half for Luperto. That was an injury sub for the center back. And Di Lorenzo took the place next to Manolas. And that's where we came also a little bit balanced. But we have to say that Sassuolo did play during the week, and after the Napoli goal, everything switched.
Mm.
So Sassuolo went down.
The momentum switched into Napoli.
Yes, and Napoli went into Napoli thinking we can win this game if we really try. And yes, it was also because of Sassuolo going down physically because they played during the week. But it's also what I saw was those plays that we haven't seen.
No, Mertens is starting to make a big difference. Mertens is starting to crank.
Those triangles that were missing the last couple of months. Now we saw more of those triangles of the old Napoli play the last 30 minutes.
Yeah, Ludo, this Insigne is unwatchable. Unwatchable. The entire first half is just he touched a couple balls here and there. Nothing. Didn't take a shot on the net. He just, he came back a couple times to touch the ball back. Nothing. It's just this guy here is supposed to be the franchise player of Napoli. He did nothing.
Mertens did well, I thought, when he came in.
Mertens,
he always brings a different pace
to the match. Mertens comes in and he changed the game for Napoli.
Which I think they need to work on that
Udinese,
renewal.
Even against Udinese, he did change
the game. Yeah, I agree.
I feel like Milik is very secluded up there. He's not getting a lot of support.
Milik played okay.
I just feel like he doesn't get the support needed, like the chances.
The problem, Alas, I think the overall problem of today.
You call him Alas?
Yeah. I call him Alas.
I don't mind. I was just asking.
I think the overall problem today of Napoli is not necessarily the style of play. 4-5-1, 4-3-3, 4-2-2. It's not necessarily that. The problem of Napoli today is in the non-possession part of the game. When Napoli loses the ball, the midfielders, the team does not compact themselves fast enough in order to keep the other team from attacking. And when you saw that every time that Napoli lost a game, the players of Sassuolo, they had 30, 40 meters like going down untouched.
Yeah,
keep going down.
Hey, your boy Locatelli, I thought, played a really good match too.
Locatelli and Traoré, great. For me, were the best on the field.
I made a joke at one point that Sassuolo's midfield was better than Juventus's. So, Gattuso, because they were so good, I thought.
Gattuso needs to work, number one, on the non-possession part of the game.
The mental approach, too.
And then the 4-3-3, guys, it will never be the same 4-3-3 like Sarri. You're missing the maestro in
ma
the middle.
Ma non rompere le palle, tu è sto maestro. No, you brought it up.
But you don't know who the maestro is.
Listen to me.
You know who the maestro is.
You just said Sarri.
No, I said the Sarri style of play. You're missing Jorginho in the middle. You're missing a player that will touch 100, 150 balls per game and will distribute and will be the balance and the brain of the midfield.
You got Fabian Ruiz.
But not,
you got Insigne. You got Alan. You got all of the top players. Those are top national team players.
He wants that connector between the defense and the midfield. Right,
the ball distributor.
Like
someone
what Pjanic is trying to do
someone
now.
Someone that decides the rhythm of the game. The one that touches those balls and gives. And then, of course, you got to make those runs also. Fabian Ruiz and Zielinski, not those types of players.
They're attacking. There's much more attacking.
Okay, so you brought up Sarri again. Okay, so fine. You brought up Sarri. Sarri was probably okay for Napoli of 3 years ago. Look what he's doing to Juventus. He's disgracing a great team. Sarri doesn't know what he's doing. To me, he's just lost over there. I think to me, he's waiting to just get sacked.
He's not going to get sacked.
No, I don't think he's waiting to get sacked.
He's not going to get sacked.
I see Juventus playing very poorly.
A couple of decisions that he made. You don't keep the guy
not
out.
Not because of today's game. Forget about today's game.
You don't keep the guy out of what?
Out of the game. You have to start De Ligt. What's his name?
De Ligt?
Yeah.
I think he had a little problem. But De Ligt, that was the furthest from the issue for me was De Ligt. Not playing. Demiral was amazing. He was the only bright spot. But Juventus, the thing that strikes me is that Inzaghi beat Sarri twice.
In two weeks.
Tactically. You know, the first game, we knew exactly what Lazio's game plan was. They were counterattacking while Juventus had most of the possession, 65% of possession, which is fine. Lazio's okay with
taking
it.
Taking the ball side by side.
Yeah.
Okay.
Passing it back and forth. And Lazio continued to break us on the counter. And I honestly feel like, and I've heard Chiellini say, you know, we're trying to learn how to defend playing so high up, which is what Sarri wants us to do, and they're not doing it effectively.
Mark, that's what we were talking about last week in the Lazio segment while he was visiting the Christmas tree. We spoke about Lazio last week, and that's what we said. I mean, Lazio, those players up front, Immobile, Correa, those
Luis Alberto, Leiva.
That's top guys. Yeah. Top quality feet.
Yes, but Juventus have top quality.
I mean, those guys, when they attack and they come at you, those passes in
but
tight spaces.
The midfield controls the game.
Listen, on a salary, if you look salary-wise, I think
it's 294 Juventus and 74 Lazio. Which is, and I'm just saying that to me, it was not the player. Yes, Lazio has great players. And I want to credit, first of all, for Lazio, they deserve to beat Juventus two
absolutely
times. They deservedly beat Juventus twice. They played very, very smart. Every single one, all 11 of those players, were ready to die for Lazio to win. And that's what's lacking. And I think that's what Inzaghi got really, really
but
right.
Do you guys
he transmits
agree?
That energy
listen
to
me,
them.
Lazio 72 million payroll, Juventus 294.
And it's not to say that, you know, money's
four
everything.
Four times. It's just not saying one, that. Not one, twice, three times. Four times the amount of money spent. And then you look at what you have on the field.
But do you also agree that today was not the game for the three guys of Juventus? Dybala,
Ronaldo, Higuain.
I know, but they're even so
when
isolated.
You see when they came out,
I don't know.
Juventus looked a little bit more.
But why well, this? Balance.
I thought that was Douglas.
Why
Costa
this imbecile is keep playing Cristiano Ronaldo on the wing? Cristiano Ronaldo.
No, then he played the middle. Then he moved to the middle.
Yeah, after, but at the end, after they took out 10 minutes.
After they took
then
out,
he moved to the middle.
But listen, by the last 10 minutes, Ludo. Yeah.
I felt like this midfield.
The game was already compromised.
The game was won in the midfield, though. Lazio just.
Won I feel and like, lost.
Yeah, they like overplayed them. You can see the small pass they're doing. They're making space for each other. They're breaking up plays so good. Build up was amazing. And that's where I feel like Juve maybe couldn't do
Lazio,
it.
Lazio win a transition.
Tactically, their
counterattacks were amazing. But before the match, we posted the three attacks where Sarri said they can't play those. And you could see how, like Ludo was touching up a little bit on
last week,
that there wasn't a lot of balance.
When he went to see the Christmas tree.
Well, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but 2 weeks ago, they played with Bernadeschi there. So if you want your balance, and the same exact result.
Listen, but.
Same result.
Yeah, the same result.
Listen,
that's
if you put
true.
Luis Alberto.
There wasn't a lot of tracking back.
Lucas Berto, Leiva, and Milinkovic, those three guys, you know, one to one with the Juventus counterpart, except for Pjanic. They overpower Juventus.
Yes, I know. I agree with that. I agree that the midfields are there. But even tactically, Juventus did not look good. They went out there, and they looked drained. Like, there was no
lack
life.
Of intensity.
And there was no hunger.
That's what bothers me the most. Yeah. And what I kept saying last year about Juventus, why it was time to move on from Allegri, was because I saw that there was a lack of intensity. The first couple of years, Juventus are very hungry. And to get this new motivation, you need to
they
change
play
things
stiff.
Up.
Juventus and is playing a bunch
I don't
of
think,
a bunch
I don't
stiff.
Think that no, Sarri no. is properly transmitting how important these games are or how to motivate these guys to go out there and play with heart and play with life and play for Juventus. You see Lazio play and they play for Lazio. You see Inter play and they play for Inter. This Juventus players, they do not.
Look his body language. They Look do the body not. Language of this guy here. He's got a little stuff on him. Then something doesn't go 100%. He turns around and he walks back to the bench. And then he gets up again. And then he chews again the stupid cigarette butt.
They just look unmotivated.
And
then
defending.
Hungry.
Defensively.
They just weren't hungry.
Defensively.
Sarri,
how bad can you be? How can you be this bad defensively?
Major problem. Sarri, again, like
he's a factor.
He used to say the maestro, the direttore, the orchestra.
Oh,
and all
Ludo,
BS.
You better defend him. Oh, he's drinking.
That
he's running up top.
BS. Sarri did not invent anything.
Ludo charging up. Ludo's charging up.
He did not invent anything. What did it invent?
Oh, Sarrismo. Sarrismo is part of the vocabulary. It's a word that's part of the vocabulary.
Explain to me Sarrismo, what it invent.
A style
Show
of
me.
Play. A style of play that was applauded all
it?
Over Europe
what
for
is
three
it?
Years.
What kind of
Sarrismo. Look on the dictionary. Look
explain
in the dictionary.
To me. Guardiola did the tiki-taka, for example, okay? Gasperini invented the 3-5-2. What did Sarri invent? Tell me, what is the system? What is the Sarrismo? What is it?
Sarrismo is the 4-3-3.
That's the BS. He didn't invent the 4-3-3.
No, the 4, it's not about inventing. It's about to interpret something. It's not about inventing. You're not in soccer. You're not reinventing the wheel. Yeah. There's nothing to reinvent. How you interpret the script. Mm-hmm. That's what he did with Napoli.
What is it that is not working with Juventus? What is
because it's not the same players. It's not the same actors. So he has
and
to adapt
that's why
Napoli
he's a bad
to the
coach.
Actors that
if
he
you
has.
Are a good coach, you're supposed to get the player that you
but
have.
But why is he a bad coach? He's still in first place. He qualified ahead of time in
you
Champions
lose.
League.
You what lost else? Two times against the same team. When you lose the first time, you make an adjustment. So the second time,
but
at least you don't
that
make
that
it look
team
bad.
Today is playing better soccer than you.
Listen to me. Within a week, you're not supposed to be losing two times. You don't. Otherwise, you don't know what you're doing. And he lost the same way. Exactly the same way.
That's what I agree with.
Where is the adjustment?
It was almost like it's like making the same mistake over and over again.
Where is the adjustment?
It's madness.
You know what he did in Inzaghi? He humiliated him. You know what he did?
Yeah, he did.
He brought again, what's his name?
Caicedo.
Caicedo.
That was the same script, the goal at the last minute.
I
get it.
But it's crazy to me how Juventus continue to make the same mistake.
He's winning 2-1 instead of just a... trying to bring the score
but
back
listen,
home and the win back
you,
home.
You don't have to need to have a top five. You don't have to have a 5-star coach to tell them to play with hunger. You know what I'm saying? They
no,
went
you
out
do
there
every
like,
day because when you have
but look
a,
at
when
that.
You have a group
they
that,
weren't hungry,
that's won
though.
For so many years in a
they
row.
They look like they didn't
you
care.
You need to have that guy behind you that's making sure that you're intense. And that's why, like, Inzaghi was really linked to a lot of teams this summer. He was linked with Juventus. He was linked with Milan, right?
Yeah,
he was linked
with so Inzaghi's making clubs. How much? $1.5 million?
We saw $1.5 million.
And this guy is making
five
what?
$5.5 million. But, and I think that Inzaghi...
If you were to pay me to coach...
Sarri also coached teams where he made less than
Sarri. I know.
Don't forget, Sarri started from the bottom.
Yeah. But I think that Inzaghi is really proving himself as a top coach right now. Because
for sure.
The mentality that he goes in to play against the top teams is second to none.
Correct.
And yes, you know, people are going to comment, oh, in Europa League. Let's be honest. They really don't have
Lazio
the deepest
right
thing
now
to play in
is
Europa
on top
League.
Of their cycle. The players that they purchased 4 or 5 years ago at very minimal amounts, now they're giving
peaking.
Dividends. They're producing dividends.
Top.
So what happened with Napoli's player then?
Which players?
The guy that the guys that you
like
have. They're not that old. You got Fabian Ruiz, you got Insigne, you got Mertens, you got all of those.
They're not the youngest.
That's a psychological approach.
A psychological
that's
approach.
A Napoli is more of a psychological approach than anything. We needed a victory. Now there's certain things that you need to work on because now Napoli, going back to Napoli, after winning after 2 months, is a lot of weight that came off your shoulders.
Okay.
So now the team is more relaxed. Now you have a week. Well, they're going to be on vacation until the 29th. Now you have a week and a half to work on the non-possession part.
Yeah, they need
to work
to get
on
this.
Certain things.
Yeah, they need
but again,
that.
You need the motivation. You need there's a lot of factors. The club,
the coach,
the fines, the coach. Ancelotti insisted on the 4-4-2. He did not want to change that style of play. He wanted to follow his ideas of the 4-4-2. And that's where the friction started with Ancelotti, that the team was not following him. The team was built not to follow that style of play. But again, Jorginho, he was never replaced, even if you want to go back to the 4-3-3.
Again, with that mentality is what I bring with what happened with Sarri, where it's the first time I've heard in I don't know how many years that a Juventus coach or somebody at Juventus said that there was a lack of motivation and a lack of mentality.
Wow, that sounds bad.
Not in this match. He said it, I think, a week ago or 2 weeks ago. Where he said there was a lack of, I think it was against Sassuolo when they
intensity,
tied.
Intensity, yeah.
They had lack of motivation to be able to get the job done. And that's the thing that scares me most of all, because that really does come down. I know that there's management, there's the players, there's the coach, but to me, that first person in line is the coach. That's seeing your players 24/7 or seeing them day in and day out where they need to be transmitted to them. And again, we can talk about the players. We can. You know, Matuidi, awful. And Bentancur, they're awful. Like, they cannot play in this midfield if you want to play that Sarri ball. Like, if you look at it, they can't. They can't. But then, at the same
time,
I'm looking at Ronaldo all the way on the left side. It makes no sense.
I don't think even Pjanic can interpret it.
Listen, maybe Pjanic. Maybe Pjanic. No, this is my take. I think Pjanic is...
He tried to convert Pjanic into a Jorginho,
yeah.
And it's not happening. Pjanic has to touch...
Pirlo, all-style Pjanic
Pirlo. Has to touch at least 100 balls a game.
Yeah. I'm not sure that it's not happening. I think that he has no support whatsoever with his options.
Guys, my opinion is I don't think Sarri will be judged based if he wins the Scudetto or not, if he comes in first or second, or if he wins the Coppa Italia. Sarri will be judged how far he's going to go into Champions League.
Yeah.
Let's not forget that Juventus had this 7 years where... teams were rebuilding. Napoli, we always say with Sarri, if De Laurentiis would have pushed a little bit more, maybe put his hands inside his pocket and done certain things, maybe we could have won something. He didn't do it. But now Inter is coming up. They're spending money. Lazio is finally, the dividends are paying for these players that they purchased 4 or 5 years ago, 5 million. They were nobodies. Now these are players.
Mm. It's very true.
They're producing.
It's very true.
So now the other teams are also coming up.
Yes.
The mentality is changing. The Serie A team is not the way it was. Oh, Juventus is a superpower. Let's all, when we play against Juventus, let's stay back and let's lose 1-0.
They fight back.
Now the courage changed.
Mm-hmm.
Now they have more determination, more courage.
At the same time, I agree. I understand where you're coming from. And I agree that, yes, Sarri will be judged off Champions League. But Sarri also needs to know that at Juventus and Juventus fans and the Juventus board, they want to win everything. Even if you, a Scudetto for them, maybe it, you know, it's become second nature at this point, but they still want to win it. They'll never accept, oh, just take second place. Oh, just lose Supercopa. Teams like Juventus, Real Madrid, all Barcelona, even if they do come in second and they win a Champions League, it's not saying that it's a failure.
You see what it's becoming?
I'm saying that it seems
guys,
like
we know, it we can't know always what the ultimate prize
good.
Is.
Listen.
We
it
know
can't what always the ultimate just be prize about is. Playing good. Sometimes you just have to be able to win. Even if you have to abandon your style a little bit and it's scrappy, you have to get out there and you
so
have to
far,
win.
So far, Sarri, and I'm not here to defend Sarri. I'm bringing the facts and numbers to the table. Sarri qualified for the next round of the Champions League before any other coach in any previous editions of the Champions League. He qualified a game or two
in
before.
In like 15 years, yeah. 15.
In 50
that
years.
That doesn't mean
years.
Anything. They got what, they mean, got lucky too. Look at the teams that they played too. Come on, look at they play scrappy team. Come on. Who did they play?
Well,
they
didn't play Real Madrid.
They didn't play Barcelona. They didn't play. They played the, with a bunch of people that they come and play on.
In life, in sports, you need to have luck. Look at Napoli. We got Barcelona. Yes, listen, we are lucky. In Champions League, we are unlucky. Usually the team that we pick in Champions League in the next round is the league, is the team that wins to win the Champions League.
Liverpool.
Look, we were talking this morning on the field when your team was defeated 7-3 this morning.
What? You didn't tell us that.
Is that by, wow.
We were talking this morning about that about that save.
We're both in the same boat today.
About that save that Alisson made on Milik.
Yeah,
against
oh my
Liverpool,
God.
The 93rd oh minute.
I remember that.
Napoli oh would have qualified. God. Liverpool would have been eliminated. And now Liverpool became Champions League and world champions.
And Napoli would have won the Champions League.
So you need luck.
Yeah,
you need
to be able to write. Bottom line is this, Ludo. Listen.
Anyway.
With this Sarri here, the Juventus is not going anywhere. He's not going. Forget about the Champions League. If you struggling into the campionato and this is the second time,
but why are you struggling? You're in first place.
Yeah, first place. It's
early. He's in first
not
place.
Not first
it's
place. Yeah, but you also beat the team that's in first.
Yeah,
that Inter's in first. You're technically
Ludo,
supposed to be 2 points ahead.
They're playing poorly. They are playing poorly. You got beat twice by Lazio. Lazio is a top of the line team. Not to take anything away from Lazio. In
Lazio
Europe,
is playing the best culture in Serie A today.
Without Atalanta.
In Europe, things are much tougher than what you play in.
So wait until February. In June,
I guess we will see at the end of the day.
You
but
you haven't spent a lot of money. Unless you spend a lot of money in January, you're not going anywhere.
No, they're not going to spend anything. They might get potted.
They might get out of the
You're not going to make the quarterfinal of the Champions
unless
League.
Unless IFTV.
Hey, that's going to be on Paratici. Who?
Unless IFTV goes bankrupt, there will be other podcasts up to May. And that's when you're going to...
There is no way that Sarri
will be judged.
Yeah, listen.
Same when you die. When you die, you will be judged.
You want to say, okay, guys, for the records, Sarri is not going past the quarterfinal. Not even, he's not going to make it to the quarterfinal. End of the story.
They're not going
to
beat Lyon?
That's what they get in Lyon.
Yeah,
on one game?
Two games.
Two games.
They're going to beat
all
Lyon.
Right. So, but that's for the day final.
Yeah, that's
so
for the
at the quarterfinal, everything is going to be over. That's it.
Okay.
And Messi will be coming in the Maradona Theater.
Listen, Juventus is not going
34
anywhere.
Years old.
Listen, they bought Cristiano Ronaldo. They bought some of the top players to win the Champions League. This is what they didn't want to give it to Conte. Now, all of a sudden, they have the player. They got a great coach with Sarri. They're not going anywhere. You guys going nowhere. Anybody that is listening over there, I feel bad because I want Juventus to win in Europe because unfortunately we don't have any other team. But this year with this Sarri, you're going nowhere. I'm sorry. You're going nowhere.
Okay. Yeah. Everybody's entitled to their opinion and we'll see the way that it
I would wait
out.
Until May.
We've already
until May.
It's still early.
We've already said.
We're chopping the gun.
Think about eating the panettone.
Yeah.
The clams. Yeah. The eel, whatever
oh my
you
God.
Eat.
Yeah, what don't we talk about? Why don't we talk about the panettone? It's Milan panettone. It's not going to taste this too good. It's going to be without racing.
But
I'm going to
talk
be...
about me. Listen,
reason,
if we have to talk about Milan, we can analyze the Milan game in 5 seconds. They never came out of the locker room.
There you go.
We analyzed
the
game. Done. Go on.
That's
Wow.
Forward.
I said it the same thing.
Am I right?
I said
you just put them in the coffin. You nailed it.
Well, they never came out of the locker room. You analyzed the game.
That was bad.
There was no game.
I said the same thing.
So it was
I actually texted to them. I said, listen, AC Milan never came out of the locker room. True. Nothing that I can do. But are we dead? No, we're not dead. It's a game.
You're not dead.
We're not dead. Milan is not dead. It's not dead. We're not going to win. We're not going to go to champions. But it's a team that we are pretty much on the same position that you guys are. You guys have 3 points, a little bit more. It's all right. Enjoy the win today because you know things are going to get a little rough.
Let's actually talk about the Milan game though. From Milan's perspective, I'll say
Very bad.
I'm very disappointed in them. I mean, there's no life. They look like...
Lifeless, yeah.
I don't want to disrespect Atalanta, but they look like what you would have... If nobody knew Serie A and nobody was informed, you would have thought that that's how they would have looked. I mean, Milan were just in their corner, never came out of the locker room, like you said.
But never, don't even go past the midfield. They were just a down 3-0. They were passing the ball back to the goalkeeper all the time.
Oh, yeah, that's what I said. They missed some chances.
I felt like... It looked like Atalanta was losing at one point, the way that they were playing.
But he still thinks Donnarumma is better than Meret.
Absolutely, by far. By far.
As a Milan fan, you had texted us and you said, this team is unbelievable. I would want everybody fired for the way How do you feel?
Look, I don't believe in Romagnoli, number one. Romagnoli is a big disappointment for us. I mean, we invested a lot of money on this kid. I mean, back then, $25 million that we took it away from Roma. That was a heck of a lot of money.
But he has no players. He doesn't have many players around.
We have no defense, okay? We have zero defense.
Besides Theo.
Yeah. Oh, Theo Hernandez, it was not playing today. The midfield, we have a few decent players. And the forward line, I would say, can be saved.
But
the defense does not exist on AC Milan. It's like you playing. You just have the door open for anybody to say, hey, come on, don't worry about it. You're not going to hit the wall. Just come in. That's it. Zero defense.
Not that many teams
zero
can compete against Atalanta. To me, that's a great soccer machine. If they're in their zone, there's nobody that can stop them.
But let me lose 2-0, I will be happy.
No, it's a perfect machine.
Let me lose 2-0.
Machine that can hurt you.
5-0.
It's a perfect machine. Those guys play with their eyes closed. They will hurt you. Mm-hmm. Any team. Today it was Milan, but today was their day.
They did it against Juve.
It could have been any other team. It would have been the same result. Mm. Don't think it was just Milan 5-0.
Yeah, but Milan also didn't do
They didn't
anything
help their
coach.
They didn't do anything.
It felt like
they let it happen.
All right, you know, just keep taking shots.
The thing is, Atalanta hasn't had Zapata in a while, and they've been scoring relentlessly. That was their top goal scorer.
They have the most goals in the league?
They do, by like four or five goals.
Yeah.
And without Zapata, they're still crushing teams by so no mercy.
Manolas, everything goes their way. It's
you
those
can't stop them,
it's
those
guys. Years, those seasons that regardless what you touch, you're gonna score with your ear, you're gonna score with your nose, you're gonna score
You're wrong.
It's luck also.
Who's the coach?
They're playing great.
Who's the coach? That is a coach. That is a coach. Not Sarri.
But that's a code for that specific team, for those players, for that city,
he fits perfectly,
for that style of play.
He fits them.
That is the code.
That doesn't think that if he goes to another team, it's going to be the same script. The script is going to change. The actors are going to be different.
Gasperini, it's 70% of Atalanta. Okay? What? Gasperini by himself is 70%. 30%, it's the player doing exactly what he's telling them.
They got to follow. No. They're following him.
I think Antonio's definitely right about that.
Gasperini.
But that was the same thing with Napoli, with Sarri.
I've been saying this for so long.
And I think what makes this Atalanta special, because I hit on the Milan, but Atalanta is a true machine. I think you put it great. They are a machine, and they're led by the guy that's controlling the machine, which is Gasperini. Oh, and they embody the spirit of what he is.
And right now, they're in the twilight zone. And they qualified for Champions League, so now they're...
No, but they've been playing like this, though.
And I think that for them, what's so impressive, like Michael said, they were without Zapata for a long time. They didn't have him in their most important match, which is a Champions League
match. Or Ilicic, too,
and
in that match.
We've seen the way teams have managed two competitions in Europe. We've seen the way that Italian teams... have not been able to manage Champions League, Europa League, whatever it is, and Serie A. And this is a team with one of the lowest budgets, the 14th lowest, I believe, in Serie A, that is managing on both fronts against tough competition, against some of the best competition. And they deserve so much respect. And I agree with him. Gasperini really embodies everything that Atalanta is. Bergamo, it fits beautifully. You could see how he was dancing at one point.
He felt so good. It was amazing.
You see that they've got this killer in their eye.
Yeah,
they never stop.
Killer instinct.
When they played against Juve was when I realized.
Confidence,
in the Coppa
Marco,
Italia,
it comes down to confidence.
They beat Juventus 3-0 in last year. And now this one. 4-0, they were not happy. They put Muriel on. He goes 5-0. They want the 6. And
they have confidence. They have self-esteem. They believe in themselves.
They should be a symbol for a lot of the smaller teams in Italy where they say, we don't have the budget. We don't have the budget. We don't have the budget. Look at the budget of what Atalanta is doing.
For every team in the world.
What do you think Conte is looking at it? There's a Conte. Oh, Conte. Inter got Conte. Conte. What is the Conte?
Now you went too far. I don't agree with this.
Let me tell you something.
Conte's got nothing to do. Conte is learning from the Gasperini system. Conte's playing the 3-5-2, right?
How do you feel? How do
he's playing
3-5-2. Conte's a great motivator.
Conte's been doing the 3-5-2. For you.
I want to play. We have a Milan question. How do you feel about the management? Because a lot of people are putting blame on Boban and Maldini.
What I mean, the management again, their hands tied too. Because you know, look at the players they got. The players are tied with the budget that AC Milan has into the.
I mean,
you know,
spend,
if you go to the supermarket, you got $10.
No, they spend.
They spend. They decided not to go, not to play Europa League, so they would have more Scarols.
Whose idea was to get Pioli? Was it Maldini's?
Well, Pioli is not the problem right now. The problem was getting Gianpaolo.
That was the problem.
Or getting Gianpaolo and not getting the players.
Exactly.
The balance of getting rid of Gattuso and not really reinforcing the players. Exactly.
And not believing the structure.
But also, at the same time, you could say, you know, maybe Piontek and Paquetá, some of the players that we spent $90 million on, not performing. Producing. And is that a byproduct of the system that Milan is right now, the environment that it is? Or is it that they weren't... good play. It's very hard to tell.
And listen,
I think they need to start.
Paquetá wants out too. Apparently, there's some rumors.
They got to start over.
It has to do with the ownership. Okay, this is the owner. Who's the ownership? It's Elliot. Okay, for someone of you that
so
you don't know.
So you're saying the fish smells from the head.
Yeah. So
rats from the head.
Yeah. Rats from the head. Yeah. So what happened? Yeah. No, what happened is this. Elliot is a group. It's a management group that is in the United States over here. That they used to be the owner of Cobelas.
Bass Pro Shop.
So what they did,
like
they
I never heard of it before. He used
Cobelas. They took they took all this town where they were situated. They fired technically everybody. Everybody lost the job. Cobelas was sold and it was bought by Bass Pro Shop. Now why am I going to this point over here? Elliot's group, it's not into soccer. Like De Laurentiis. De Laurentiis loves soccer.
It's a numbers game.
Okay, it's a numbers game. So what they're doing, they saw this opening. They said, hey, let's invest those money. It's cheap. We were hoping the commisso will be the one by AC Milan.
I don't think it was cheap.
No, I think
they got the team for 170 million.
They took it back because the other ownership couldn't pay.
Right.
They're holding right now. They're holding.
I don't know, what's the word when you take it? I don't remember the word.
They saw this opportunity as one of the best franchises in the world. They got the franchise for 170 million, I believe. Boom. They got the team. They said, hey, we're going to just do a few things and we're going to flip it. Now, what they did was not smart. Hey, we'll flip it like Mike. What they did was not smart. And here we are now, just crying after the fact.
Yeah, but they got the right people. They got people like Boban, Maldini. You have management.
Right people,
They're soccer people. They lived soccer. They breathe soccer 24 hours a day all their lives.
But what do you think was a good idea to fire Gattuso if they were breeding good soccer and things like that?
The ownership wanted to change. They wanted to start from the beginning. They wanted to bring something new. But now remember, you also need to have the ownership of management,
because ownership about soccer, they don't understand anything.
Yeah, they hire the management.
They hire the management to make that move.
Management, you're talking about the guys like the Maldini and the Boban.
Yeah.
No, it's those guys that decide we want to break away from the past and start something new.
Mm. Yeah, exactly. That's what you're saying.
The thing is now, you also need to have a great scouting team around you or create a scouting team that can get the right players from the right parts of the world.
It's very deep problems.
And bring it in. It's not only about Boban and you also need, there's a team that works around these guys.
We had Kaká in the beginning and then Kaká then left.
Kaká? Who was Kaká before he came?
We had Leonardo, we had Kaká, we had a bunch of...
So you need scouts that go in different parts of the world that know the talents. Okay, this is good for me.
It's a very deep problem.
It's not easy. It's a building... process. Nothing happens.
But the main thing is nothing that happens is the head. If you stink it from the head, the rest of your body is going to stink. Believe me.
Eventually.
The way we said it, to me, this Elliot group, it's just bad. So the sooner, I mean, I would be so happy that we stay where we are right now, AC Milan, into the Classifica. I don't care about qualifying for the UEFA, qualifying for this. I mean, of course, I would love to qualify even to win the whole thing.
Realistically, but let's
wait it out. We'll wait it that the storm goes by. And then we'll see if something changes with the ownership. Maybe somebody's going to wake up and say, hey, AC Milan is for sale. Let's put the money on the table. Let's bring AC Milan for someone that is loves the game and loves AC Milan. So
Louis Vuitton.
Louis Vuitton. That's what you said once, right?
Peter
said. So anyway.
Guys, the money was spent in Milan. It's just that the dividends didn't happen.
Not in the right places.
Look at Piontek, 35 million in January. How many goals has the guy scored?
Not much.
Nothing.
To talk about reinforcements, the last thing before we go on to Inter, I really hope that Atalanta, that they spent some money in January. I think they need depth. If you're going to keep going in these competitions, you can't go in to your next match. Who do they play? Valencia. You know, without Ilicic, without Zapata. You need to
when
have guys that can give
come
them
back, Mike. When is
supposed apparently to be? Apparently in a week or two, he's supposed to actually be playing.
But he was supposed to be back also for the Latin game, and then he never came back.
It was a little more serious.
Muriel is not a second. Muriel is a good player.
Muriel does the most damage when he comes from the bench.
100%.
Muriel is not
even like Mertens. Look at Mertens.
I agree.
Mertens, there's a reason why you put certain players in the last 30 minutes. They changed that game.
You think it's for a reason that Gattuso makes him come in?
Yes. It's super
strong. No, 100%.
Why didn't Ancelotti understand that then, Ludo?
He did put him in. He never, certain games he started, he wanted
to rotate.
Like we said with Ancelotti, he was more of a president's coach. When he was hired, I'm sure this is the conversation. Ancelotti, you want to become the coach of Napoli? You are not to commit the same mistake that Sarri did.
Play the same people.
Right, 13 players, 14 players, and the others, they fall asleep on the bench for 34 games.
Got it.
So, Ancelotti said, yes, I will. So he tried to
make everybody
incorporate
happy.
Everyone.
To make everybody play everyone.
Let's go to the next one. Inter 4-0 against Genoa. Absolute thrashing, right? Genoa, one that kind of didn't really come out of the locker room.
They
in
laid
this
over.
One. Thiago Motta.
Ballardini will be the coach of Genoa.
That's what
again,
we're just...
which he was the first coach. Yeah. Right?
He was on the. He was watching the Sassuolo Napoli game today.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Ballardini was watching the Sassuolo Napoli game today because Genoa will play against Sassuolo the next match. So Ballardini is becoming the next coach of Genoa.
Honestly,
watching
it's so
the next
embarrassing.
Yo,
it's so embarrassing.
It's like a carousel of all these Serie A coaches that just keep recycling
for
over
for people
to
that don't know,
teams.
Ballardini was the coach at the beginning of the season. Yeah. They sacked him. They got Thiago Motta for 3 weeks now, 4 weeks. And now they're about to take back the guy that's still on their payroll that they had sacked.
Same thing happened with Brescia.
And
the
Thiago
same
Motta
thing.
Is about
look,
to... Where we,
like
said,
to
we said Thiago Motta was not
even,
ready to coach.
Even 20 seconds I would like to spend on Gianpaolo. I mean, Gianpaolo, so far... He has been a great coach with all the teams that he's been in. Sampdoria, great soccer. Okay, no, I'm getting there. Oh. With other teams that he has coached. Yes, in Milan, he did not fit that project. He was sacked. But now they don't even mention him.
His name.
A name in taking any team. Not even 5% chance of coaching.
He's keeping that Milan paycheck. He doesn't want to ruin it now.
No, let me relax a little bit. To get mentioned to say, okay, he's probably... But I think he's going to start with a Serie B team. He's going to start with a brand
really?
New project.
I don't know about Serie B.
Serie B?
I think it really hurts somebody. Like, the psychological... Nobody ever talks about that. Like, psychology of a freaking coach that gets sacked. And I know, you know, they get sacked and they got a lot of money.
But then they usually come back into the game. They
messes with your head where you're like, oh my God.
Too.
Especially that jump, you know, where we talk about Gasperini who made that jump to Inter and then you get sacked.
Thinking you're not good
jump,
enough or
exactly,
something.
Exactly, that's what I was trying to get
course.
At. But anyway, I know.
But then you see the paycheck. Then you see the paycheck and then
Gasperini with Gianpaolo.
And also the manager that you have and the impact that he has on the presidents, on the owners
let's
of the team.
Inter
with apples, okay?
Inter 4-0, Lukaku.
Killed it.
Again, yeah,
two goals,
Mike,
Lautaro. Lautaro didn't play. They didn't have any midfielders, so they brought in like the Primavera player, Aguame or something like that.
He played the match before against Fiorentina.
Yeah, I think he was on the bench. Did he?
No,
he
came in.
He came
against
in?
Fiorentina, yeah.
But yo, Genoa, they didn't do anything.
You didn't mention Esposito.
Esposito's
from Castellammare di Stabia.
Oh, is he?
Oh, is he?
Yes.
He's Napolitano?
Of course.
Oh, wow. That's where Fabio's from.
2002.
Anybody with a last name Esposito.
Guys,
remember this.
Yeah. Campania. The Campania region.
Yeah, they have some of the best players, I know.
And is
pool,
the Argentina
right?
of soccer. Campania region
the best talent,
produces...
Right?
Argentina
yes,
of Italy.
The best talent. 99% of them are dickheads and they don't make it. But if they would have their head on the shoulders, there would be more talent coming out from Campania
for
region.
For all the listeners, I think you know, Ludovico got a couple shots.
No, I'm not saying.
He started this episode with a bang before we even drank anything. So this is
he's a little wobbly if he starts walking.
The best region that produces champions is the Puglia. Forget about the Campania. Campania, they only produce
the best olive oil.
Mozzarella only they produce over there.
You
forget
produce
about
the best extra virgin olive oil, period. And the burrata.
Forget the burrata.
So what Ludo was saying, Esposito, he got his first start for Inter
2002,
ever.
2002, correct.
And they got a penalty, and Lukaku, who was supposed to take it, gifted him the ball, and Esposito perfectly hit it. He was crying. He went. He hugged his mom. Unforgettable night for him.
He said, he said after the match.
Neapolitans are very dramatic.
Oh, okay.
He said, I didn't sleep at all last night. I spent the whole time thinking about what would happen today, and I couldn't have dreamt of a better evening. So for a 17-year-old, really good. Happy for him.
And I'm happy that I'm seeing more of these 17, 18-year-olds.
Young talents play.
It's not always a chance to play.
A good point, Ludo. Why, you know, you're losing 3-0, 4-0 with Atalanta. Why doesn't this guy here, Pioli, bring a couple young kids over there on the bench? Put them in. Just put them in. Nothing. I don't see any of those things. Why we have a good youth.
Atalanta is one of the best in Italy.
Yeah, but
Atalanta is one of the best youth system in Italy.
Has got a bunch of talents too, but they've been sitting on the bench for a long time.
The Ajax of Italy, right? Their youth. You can say it like that.
Inter just monster. I didn't expect anything less.
They were
them.
Dancing all over them.
They were just, even with, like you said, so many injuries, so many different things that happened to them. They're another one who, they know how to get the job done. I think Genoa was lifeless. That was their last hope to keep Thiago Motta, was to try to get a result.
Yeah. Right.
Much like kind of Fiorentina and Montella was, which we'll get to next. They weren't able to, and I think not too much from Inter, but good that they put 17-year-old Lautaro comes out, steps up to the plate. Yes, it was a penalty, but still, good job for the 17-year-old. Let's talk about Fiorentina. 4-1 loss to Roma. Montella sacked after the match from Fiorentina. You know, the management had said he has two games to save him. They didn't say save himself, but they said he's got two more games for sure.
And then we'll evaluate the situation.
And then we'll see what happens. Yeah. Tied at the very last second to Inter. And against Roma, they had absolutely no shot. Again, playing at home. But Fiorentina were nowhere near on the level that Roma was on. They ended up sacking Montella, and I think they're expected to get Iachini soon. It wasn't not official, but
he's a likely favorite.
I think he's a likely favorite. It was between him, Prandelli. They were even talking about Di Biagio. In my opinion, I don't think any of them.
I would have kept Montella.
I would have kept Montella. If you're gonna go to that route, I think if you would have gotten Gattuso, I would have said yes, 100%. If you don't get Gattuso and Iachini, Di Biagio and Prandelli, I'd rather just stick with Montella.
Ludo, what do you think of those options?
Well, I believe that mistakes were made all around. I won't just based on what we have, what we have seen. I don't just blame
Montella's got nothing
Montella,
to be blamed.
100%. It was also, I think, part of the management of balancing this team with some experienced players that can score a certain amount of goal. And I guess he requested certain things, and he was not. His words were not taken into consideration, and the management decided to go in a different way. You still need players that could put these balls in the net. They wanted to go with experience and young. He wanted a little bit more of balance.
Right.
And that's what I think.
Plus a couple contingencies, like Ribery getting hurt, Chiesa.
Correct.
With his head, it's not 100% on the game. And then, even when you hurt, okay, this is what the things that bothers me the most of Chiesa. The kid has got talent. He's playing in Florence. The ownership is behind this kid here 100%. I'm not sure what's going on in the head of this kid here. Hey, even when you are 100%, let's say 100% injured, you have to wear your sweatpants and your sweatsuit, sit down on the bench and support your team instead of being on the tribune. Listen to me.
If you can't play, why would you be on the bench?
No, you wouldn't be on the bench.
But you won't be on the bench if you can't
play. I don't
know
if he's actually hurt. I think that's one of the things to say.
Is he 100% hurt? Is that true that is this guy here?
That game he couldn't play. He was not even called up the day before.
Yeah.
The coach makes a list.
Oh, yeah.
24 hours before. These are the players that are going to go
on the roster.
What I meant to say, Ludo, is I'm not saying just be on the bench because you might be called in. No, just to support your teammate. Or talk to them. I said, hey, by the way, just be part of the...
A lot of factors played into Montella's sacking. It's not only that he didn't do a good job. Yes, a little bit was his fault. You discovered a couple of players. Vlahovic, I think, in the future.
Out of his some of
but,
his guys.
But based on what he was... The hands, the card that he was given, he didn't have much of a he didn't have much of a chance.
I agree with that. And I saw, just to say the stats.
But the team is a good team, though. It's a good team. Why we keep saying that? Fiorentina is a good team.
Since Quintero returned.
Too young and a couple too experienced should have been more
balanced.
Mm. More balanced.
Plus, Ribery's out for a little while now.
Since Montella returned to Fiorentina, he played 24 Serie A games. He lost 13 of them. And out of a potential 72 points, he only got 19. Mm. It's bad. No matter, even with like the players that they have,
you can't
bad.
Sugarcoat that anyway.
I agree with you that there is a balance of blame.
Even look
but
at
I feel
the
like,
defense sometimes, you know, the yeah. mistakes that they made. Shaking. In positioning.
Communication.
I just feel like Montella's not able to get... He's not able to get mad and get his guys going and to save his career. But let's give credit to Roma.
A classic, an old coach, which I respect very much, Giovanni Trapattoni once said, you cannot make silk ties from cotton. You cannot produce silk ties from cotton.
This sounds like Conte's thing with the restaurant.
It ain't happening.
Exactly. So
that's
wait,
the bottom line.
Okay, but I don't want to get into it. Never mind. I'll let it go.
Let's talk about Roma.
Roma, yes. Roma non fa la stupida stasera.
Look at this guy, Zeppi, just because he won one game after 10 times. Oh,
Roma
God.
Looks so solid, man. Just in defense, midfield, and attack, they look like one amazing unit. They have each other's back. They fight for each other, passionate. They die for the ball. They just look great. They're having
team.
A good season.
They're a team.
And under new Fonseca, I doubted Roma, but yo, they're proving me wrong, and I'm happy they're
Fonseca's
proving me wrong.
Done
they're looking
great.
Hey,
first year in Serie A. This is also the same.
This is a real team.
Ludo's winding up before he winds up.
I need a little drink before I wind up.
No. Grab him the thing. But before you say that, I just want to say that Roma, this is also what Roma did against Fiorentina was also what Inter couldn't do against Fiorentina. Same Fiorentina side, same guys missing, same in Florence, and Roma made them look just horrible. Just absolutely horrible.
Yeah.
And that's credit to Roma and credit to Fonseca, who's doing great things with them. Zaniolo, Pellegrini, I love... Roma's a fun team to watch.
Yeah.
They've become just a team that you can enjoy watching because they play good football. I'm sorry, Ludo. I hand
no,
it off
I,
to you.
I do agree with you guys that Fonseca is doing a tremendous job, and I hope he continues to do so. But if we go back and we read a little bit of history, most of the coaches that Roma's had before Fonseca, they all have done a tremendous job the first season.
Rudy
coaching
Garcia.
The team.
Now you're making me think. Now.
Then the second year, that's when the problems
arise.
But now,
holy shit.
Problems were arising because you had two gentlemen in the locker room that they're no longer there. Now, will history repeat itself?
What are you talking
September?
About? Rossi and De Rossi?
De Rossi and Totti. So now, do you think history will repeat itself back in September? Is the team playing better, more concentrated because the ownership is willing to sell and they're thinking already that someone new is coming in, so the team is playing with they're more relaxed. So yes, right now they're playing well. Let's see how they finish the season. They're producing and they're playing great soccer. Love to watch them play. It created a nice group in the locker room. Like everyone did in the past. But now let's see what happens
next
once
season.
July, August comes around the next season. Let's not forget that Roma reached
the
semifinal
League.
Of the Champions League. Roma had great players, which means great scouts. Remember, those players did not come to Roma just because the plane landed in Rome. Here I am, I want to play. They were taken to Roma. Allison. Nainggolan,
Salah,
other players that were sold, and Roma reached the semifinal, and they didn't keep that team together. So something that they start, a project that usually is started, it never finished.
Gets sold off.
It gets sold off because Roma needs to sell, ownership needs to sell, in order to bring money in because of the deficit, or because of the. You know,
we blame the Monchi too.
The financial fair play, whatever.
Correct. And all that.
That's very good. And I think that it's also leading up to a really great Champions League spot because those last, I mean, Napoli, Inter and Juventus are going to take the first one and two.
And then third
and
fourth is going to be
there's Atalanta, there's Lazio, there's Roma, there's still Napoli, there's Cagliari who are all in that contention. Milan, sorry.
Well, now Napoli has a great game. Napoli, the next game that Napoli will play, to me, it's a thermometer. Next game, we're able to tell Napoli's temperature. Mm-hmm. It's in...
with the Cagliari?
No, Inter.
Oh, Inter. Crap. I forgot about that.
When we come back from the... after the Panettone.
January, right?
I think
January
6th. He's
got to rile his guys up.
Okay.
So now this is
we can go to Napoli. Is that a Napoli or in Naples? They play in Naples, right?
I think it should be in Naples.
Okay, yeah.
No Koulibaly.
I don't know that. I don't know.
Because I know he's gonna be out for. He's injured, bro. Like 3 weeks.
That's ridiculous. That is freaking. Yeah,
maybe Manolas can get the job though.
So that will be Napoli's thermometer based on this win, and hopefully they can.
Marco was so happy now. His spirits are so
reunited, and it feels so good.
Ludo, we were talking about Roma before, right?
Roma.
So what happened with Di Francesco? You know, Di Francesco.
Yeah, where's he been?
Di Francesco,
he's
another player.
He's lost.
Di Francesco. Wait,
why is that?
Di Francesco brought Roma.
Palladini.
Di Francesco. Di Francesco brought Roma to the semifinal of the Champions, right? So him is disappearing too from the major.
Well, maybe he's taking a break.
Mochi, here's what happens.
He hasn't said anything.
Sometimes. Sometimes when the ownership gives too much room to the management, that's what happens. Mm-hmm. Pallotta, let's not forget, he lives
in New York.
He lives in Boston. Now he has those people and they work for him. Commisso also lives in New York. He goes back and forth, but he has Joe that's there 24 hours a day, overlooking the entire operation.
I love it.
Now,
by the way, for you guys that you don't know who's Joe, Joe is our friend. Joe Mike, Barone is our friend.
Now,
is our friend.
The guy, the manager who got sacked from Roma, he had complete control. He did make certain mistakes, and he hired Di Francesco, and that was one of the errors that he made. But also, I don't want to, let's say, hit Di Francesco on the head, but when Di Francesco took over, guys. Read who was sold.
Oh, yeah.
That team was completely... In order to have a successful team, you need the owners to be with the team.
Yeah, yeah.
Look what happened now. Where was... I mean, we keep going back to Naples.
Don't you think that Di Francesco will fit at the Fiorentina's project right now?
Oh yeah, I would take Di Francesco.
I would take
Fiorentina.
Him. I mean, over Giacchini. What the hell?
100%.
Giacchini.
Yeah,
100%.
But also depends on the salary that he had before.
Giacchini's like a farmer. I don't picture
don't
him like
on the salary that he had.
He's gonna get
De Laurentiis. De Laurentiis is on the field.
He's a player.
He's been next to the team. Today he was next to the warm up of the team. Gattuso is next to the team as well.
So you
need the ownership to
and
be.
And that's what you don't see on AC Milan.
To be a presence.
That's what you don't see on AC Milan. Those guys are working numbers over here from New York or from wherever they are. Okay, let's see the quotation. It's going up, it's going down. Yeah, let's wait a little bit.
They need
more.
To send your buddy Costa.
I'm telling you.
Go take care of those guys.
So anyway.
But Roma, we wish that Roma does well. I really like the way. Yeah,
like I was going to
really
say
like
about
them. The way he plays.
Those five teams that I mentioned, I think that they all play really good football. Like one thing that's consistent between Roma, Lazio, Cagliari, Napoli, Atalanta, Napoli, not so much. Just to give credit to them. I think it's going to come down to who's really strong up top and mentally.
Well, Cagliari lost two games in a row.
That's what I was...
It's not the same Cagliari as before. The intensity is not there. The pressure is not there. It's not the same Cagliari as it was.
But as we get longer into the season, we're going to start seeing that it's not just going to come down to the basis of how you play. It's going to be how you can consistently have that right mental edge where you're able to pick up these points against Udinese, against whoever might be in front of you. So that's why it's leading up to a really good race.
I strongly believe, here saying it today, I strongly believe that Lazio can put themselves into the Scudetto.
People got so mad at you for saying that. People
that's my
really
belief.
Let me put something on the table then. You know, it's got a good point.
People
I'm not,
we're putting
I, too
much
I did
pressure,
not say,
by the way.
I did not say that they're going to win the Scudetto. I say take Lazio into consideration. If the toy is not going to break, if the locker room stays together psychologically,
oh, absolutely,
physically, mentally, the team stays together, and Inzaghi is able to keep the group compact, I'm sure they can have their saying
Until they have the team too.
If you flip the coin,
they're 3 points behind, and they have one game to play.
3 points,
Marco. If you flip the coin, listen to this.
Oh, they're tied
three,
with games.
Three below. Okay, three below.
Yeah, three.
Listen, if you three below with one game in hand.
No, one game in hand.
They're gonna play one game.
They play it.
They're not three below. No, they're five below with one game in hand.
Okay, one game in hand. Oh, okay. So let's flip the coin now. So this, the flipper. This Sarri, okay. This Sarri now, having lost the Supercoppa today against Lazio, he's going to get an extra motivation because there is a chance that this guy here, he's got Inter breathing on their neck. They are first place both teams. And he doesn't have a great chance to win the Champions League. So for him...
Who said he doesn't have a great chance to win the Champions
League? I don't think so. Sarri. No, the question is this.
No, we meant from people.
Sarri, for me, is going to have to put a lot more attention on the campionato, on the championship, the Italian championship, because there's a very great chance that Juventus this year doesn't win crap.
And if they don't, that would be a big deal. For Juventus. So
obviously,
you know, because this situation just becoming reality. Yeah. Sarri's goodbye. He's goodbye. I don't care how many years contract they gave it to him. Juventus is not going to leave.
They only gave him 3 years. It's only gave him 3 years.
They gave him 3 years.
Only 3 years. Well, which is kind of low.
Three years too many.
This is still 2019.
Yeah, it's not even January.
It's too early. Anyway,
it's too early,
Mike. Get some questions.
Yeah, I have.
Don't we say something about Bologna before? Bologna is...
They won 3-2 against Lecce.
Great tortellini.
Lecce almost came back, man. They were down 3-0. They scored two goals, one in extra time, and they almost had one back. But Bologna fought. And
a big shout out to Mihailovic again. They're still fighting. So
I love that Spal beat Torino, by the way. I love that.
That was extremely weird.
Are we going to have another one?
Also,
I don't think the team is following.
Brescia almost got away with a win. If they won, they would have hopped out of relegation zone. But Parma scored 93rd minute.
Yo,
and
Spal won, and they're still in relegation zone. They're still in 19th place.
It's insane.
I don't think they moved at all. I don't know what the hell happened to Torino. Anyway,
okay,
sorry.
Let me start with a question. This one's from Logan. He said, "If you had to start over with the top clubs in Italy, what's one player you would keep on their current roster? First one, Juve."
Sorry, I don't understand.
One person you keep to build around for each team.
Oh, okay.
Juve. What do you think, guys?
Wow, it's hard. Between Dybala and...
Matuidi?
I would say Dybala.
Dybala.
And even Ronaldo?
To build around?
Oh, to build around Dybala.
Habba Napoli.
Meret.
Mm-hmm. Butter.
Butter figure. Oh, speaking about butter, did you see what De Gea did today?
Who?
De Gea. De Gea from Manchester United.
No, I didn't see that.
You see that?
Yeah, he's copying.
Butter!
How about Inter?
Inter.
Senzi? Barella?
Inter's got
Skriniar?
Skriniar. Yeah.
Lautaro? People would argue Lautaro.
Yeah.
I would say...
So which one?
I would say...
They're all very good.
I would say Barella.
Maybe Barella. Skriniar. He's a captain. Okay. He's going to stay there.
You have one? He doesn't even care.
I would say Lautaro.
Lautaro.
I like the way...
Okay. Milan.
Donnarumma.
Yeah, I guess that's only one. Who else could you keep?
Romagnoli.
Theo Hernandez.
I will keep the panettone.
No. Romagnoli.
That's the only thing in Milan left after Donnarumma is the panettone.
I think you're going to have me. Theo. Oh, I say Theo Hernandez.
Yeah, but Donnarumma is a leader, though.
It's easier to find the goalkeeper than it is a good left back.
I guess. You can argue that.
Same way you had Buffon for a long time. You know what? I keep saying, and I will say it again in front of all my friends over here. If Donnarumma has to be sold, either at Napoli, that I will be very happy if he goes to Napoli.
Napoli
will
be okay for the next 15 years. Thank you very much.
You don't have that quality. You just have butters over there. Too many butters.
Wait, what did you call Meret?
Puro.
Meret?
What do you remember?
He had the diaper finger, whatever.
No, it's diaper finger. He called him butter ass.
Ass finger. Ass butter.
You wish.
Butter ass.
Butter ass. You wish you had Meret.
The ball went under his ass. So instead of butter finger, it's butter ass. But you know what? To finish up, if I would love to see Donnarumma being sold from AC Milan, I would want to see him in Juventus or Inter or any other place. Napoli is the only place that I like to see Donnarumma.
Which is the only place that doesn't need him.
Okay? And we'll take Meret and we'll put him on the bench. We'll let somebody, you know, we'll bench Meret because it's not a...
Okay, let me finish this. Roma.
Let me take this away.
Roma, who we put in? Mancini?
Roma.
Zaniolo.
Oh, Zaniolo.
Zaniolo.
Right?
Yeah.
A Lazio.
Lazio, you have a few.
Luis Correa, right?
No, Luis Alberto.
He's old.
He's got to be older.
Correa. He's like 28. Luis Alberto's not that old.
When I see Correa play, that ball glued to his feet, the way he moves with that style, it's like watching Dancing with the Stars.
It's like poetry.
Yeah,
you
know. And Atalanta.
Why only Atalanta, Papu.
Just like the top.
Still, Papu's still young.
Papu's older.
No, it's not Derun.
Derun.
Marta. Papu Gomez is a player.
Yeah, but you can't build around
him. Did we say everyone? Cagliari? Should we throw Cagliari in there? Who's Cagliari have?
Atalanta, I say Golini. That's what I say.
Great goalkeeper. I like him also as a goalkeeper.
And I just went against what I said about it's so easy to find the good goalkeeper, and then I chose a goalkeeper.
Golini.
But I didn't know who else to choose.
Cagliari, we're going to do João Pedro. He's old, though, right?
Man, who the hell are you going to say for
Cagliari? Nine goals this year. The guy scored.
Cragno's coming back, I heard.
He's been injured for so long.
But he scores great goals.
Nico Yannis.
João Pedro scores great goals, man.
Nico Yannis. What the hell are you talking about?
You said the wrong name. You said Nico Yannis.
Nico Yannis.
Nico Yannis. We're the same guy. Okay.
Any other
question?
Yeah, let me get the next one. Ludo, this one's from Joe. He said, have you seen a difference under with Napoli under Gattuso than with Ancelotti? And what?
The only difference I saw was the in the style of play of the 4-3-3. That's the only difference. But the difference I saw today was the last 30 minutes. After Alan scored, which was a goal that he really wanted, and he really... He looked like a forward, the way he used his body, and then he let that shot go. Napoli changed everything.
Wait.
The last 30 minutes were extremely romantic.
How about attitude, though, towards the team? Do you see anything more positivity, more hunger, more passion, fighting more, anything or not?
No, it's not that, Manolas. What I see is the biggest issues, what we said before, is when Napoli loses possession. When Napoli loses possession, you want to cover your eyes. Nobody knows what to do. Nobody knows where to go, who to pick up, how to become compact.
So
you
want to
cover your eyes. But when the last 30 minutes, again, it was a psychological. Napoli took so much weight off their shoulder. I saw the old Napoli the last 30 minutes. The triangles, those little triangles, the giving goals, the opening up into space, hugging again. It's like a rebirth. That's what I saw.
Listen, this guy here has been talking like that because 3 seconds before the end of the game, they got so lucky that they scored that game. Imagine if we missed the goal, if the score would have been 1-1, we wouldn't have been talking
Meret
like that.
Meret kept us in the game. I'm not saying that. But, Meret kept us in the game.
But anyway.
Last question. This one's for Anto. He said, do you think it was the right decision to start Leao over Piontek?
Listen, we have two players that they are outdoing each other. Leao, I think he hit a couple posts.
I wouldn't say outdoing each other.
Listen, didn't Leao hit two posts last night played against Sassuolo?
He did Sassuolo, yeah.
Okay, so the problem is that they need to freaking put the ball inside the net.
May I say something?
Yeah,
of course. Please.
90% of the time, when you see certain players starting over other players, it's not a game time decision. It's a weekly decision. Mm. Remember, Pioli, now we're talking about Milan, he sees these guys every single day, twice a day at practice.
Yeah, yeah.
If Pioli thought that Piontek was not aggressive enough, was not mentally in the practices during the week, they not do the right thing, he's not going to start him on Sunday, period. Even me, as a youth coach in soccer, the exact same thing. I watched the practices, even though we practice twice a week. You gave me 150% at practice, you're going to start. You're going to be lazy at practice, you're not starting on the weekend.
Let me ask you a question. If that lazy guy comes in with a Napoli shirt one day, do you start him over the guy?
Absolutely not.
If he comes with a bottle of limoncello, would you start him?
Absolutely not.
Oh, boy. I don't know. That's a coach I need right there.
He's
going to be bringing a bottle of
limoncello. Oh, yeah.
All right. Wait, there's a couple other funny ones that I want Antonio to answer.
Okay.
One said, what does Antonio think of Lukaku?
Lukaku, you know, he rhymes with something that I don't want to say on the podcast. But Lukaku, it's not a caliber player of $80 million. It's not worth $80 million. To me, Lukaku,
Still early. Kaka. Still learning to score.
I don't know what you're trying.
He was just going to say Kaka or something.
Yeah. Oh, okay. You said
it doesn't rhyme, but it doesn't rhyme.
I have a clean mouth, but Lukaku is not a Riccardi. He's just
a good player.
So you didn't want to say Kaka, but you said butter ass for a minute. Let me just get this straight.
Lukaku cannot be substituting a caliber player like Icardi. End of the story. I don't think it's worth
he's
the money.
Scoring at the end of the
doesn't
day.
Matter well, what he's doing.
Scoring. Well, he's scoring in certain matches. I think
because of Lukaku, Inter is out of the Champions League. Let me remind you. Icardi, you give him 2 balls, 1.5, he puts them in. Okay? Lukaku, you have to give
there's
them 2 balls.
There's a finisher.
Balls.
There's a
Icardi
reason.
Icardi is a finisher.
There's a reason Icardi's not there, though.
Lukaku, he's too scared when he gets in front of goal. He doesn't have this calmness that I think a lot of great strikers have.
About this
yeah,
yeah.
I think, you know, he just bombs the ball.
Regardless, killer instinct. First season in the Serie A, Lukaku's been positive for me overall, I think.
One thing I want to say about Lukaku, which I had said earlier on in the season, what strikes me the most about Lukaku is not his ability. It's his attitude. And I think he's got one of the best attitudes.
He's got a great heart.
The guy really plays
for his team. He's a team
player. He honestly does not care if he scores or if he passes the ball.
It's a team.
I mean, not
the team
just,
has to
not,
win, period.
And it doesn't mean just
it's not about
giving
himself,
the ball.
It's about the team.
And it's not about giving the ball to Esposito. Yes, that's one part, but it's not even the biggest. I thought that was made a crazy deal, which is... This is Lukaku. Like, I see him, he really sacrifices for the team. He listens to instructions. He never says no. He never does this. And that's what strikes me the most about Lukaku that I want to give him credit for. He's a true professional.
Friendly giant.
He's
right
a real
there.
True professional. Yeah.
But that's what I think was the determination of Conte to say, I want Lukaku because this guy will say, yes, sir.
Agreed.
He's
yes.
a team player yes. and not Icardi that
100%.
Himself to himself. But now,
kidding
I want
me.
To say something.
Are you kidding me? Conte had no decision about Icardi, believe me.
Absolutely.
Conte had nothing to
argument.
Do with that. First
really
of all, Conte is too stupid to understand.
Come on.
He's an idiot. He's too stupid to understand that Icardi is a real champion. What the hell does he know about
Icardi
soccer?
Is a champion.
It's not because, something. But listen, if you're a champion, you got to be a champion 360 degrees.
Why?
Not only that, playing 90 minutes... does not determine if you're a champion or not. You're a champion on and off the field.
Why? Because he didn't like that Vandanara said something on the that he shouldn't
it
have said and all that stuff?
Now, the thing with Conte is one of the last coaches in Europe. There are very few.
Yeah.
You could count them on your fingers. That
he's
if
overrated.
You want him,
yeah.
no, you
yeah,
want him yeah. on your team, I need 100% control. I decide everything soup to nuts. Who goes, who stays. Otherwise, don't hire me.
I disagree with you.
That is,
not
that's
the
no,
truth.
No, that is.
I would say it's Marotta that made that decision. Marotta made that decision.
Well, but
before,
it's Conte, the type of coach that he, if you want him, it's got to be his way or
Conte,
the highway.
Icardi's decision
second,
was there
second,
before
Conte. No, no,
Conte's been biting his ass. I said, oh, I wish I had Icardi because Marotta
listen,
got rid of him.
Let me say one thing. You're both right and you're both wrong in the one sense, which is, yes, that Conte definitely needs full control over every decision. But at the same time, the Nainggolan came out and said, Conte said, I want you on my team. Nainggolan gave it an interview. You can go and search it on YouTube. He said, Conte told him, I wanted you when I was at Juventus. I wanted you when I was at Chelsea. And now I finally have you. And they told me that the decision is done.
Yeah.
That you are gone. That no matter what I want... I cannot have you.
The decision was made already.
Exactly.
It was
this
made already.
Because
yes.
He found
yes.
out on a
so he's right.
It was in a discotheque on a Saturday.
He said that it was the decision that the club made and Conte
no,
said I had to respect
it's going to a discotheque 6 days a week. Not
listen
only
to
once.
Me. Listen to
but
me.
I'm just saying about
listen,
that.
Listen, please. Listen to
me.
If you want to talk about Nainggolan, if Nainggolan had issues with Milan, I can understand one side of the issue. But the same issues with the national team. Why doesn't he get called for the national team?
Listen to me. You don't understand soccer. That's the problem.
Oh, my God.
When you have,
oh, my God.
When you have... Listen to me. Listen. You're not listening. When you have talents in your team, you're not supposed to tell them what to do with their private life. Whether they're going to go to bed with
me?
One lady or two ladies.
Are you kidding
listen
me?
Listen to me. You're not listening. You don't tell Cassano what to do with the ball.
Why
you don't tell,
revolve around
you don't tell Zidane what to do. You don't tell Dybala where to go. You don't tell those players because you don't know.
It was only one player that
Maradona.
Yeah, correct.
No. There are few. Questi
absolutely
sono chiamati
no.
palleggiatori. You do not tell people that know to play soccer what they do. do with their private life?
You're a professional. You act as a professional. You follow rules and regulations.
When it starts affecting your game, then it does.
What game? What game? This is not the army. Nainggolan has performed 100% of the time.
I pay you $5-6 million a year. You do what I say. You are an employee. Even though I said, even going back to Napoli, it was wrong Napoli not to go to the retreat. De Laurentiis pays their salary.
Yes.
It was wrong.
On that, I agree
but
with
you. But Nainggolan, that smokes a certain amount of cigarettes a day, that has a private life like Vidal, and that's why he was sold from Juventus, you have to maintain a certain... Now...
So tell me now, Nainggolan has stopped because he went to Cagliari, the guy still smoking.
But that's a different team. It's a discotheque. But now, if you allow Nainggolan to do it, now you're opening a can of worms to allow the other teams to do... I mean, the other players to do the
but
same
at
thing.
At the same time, Nainggolan did not create any problems.
There's rules and regulations.
He didn't create any problems like they say Icardi made. If he smokes, yeah, but he runs more than everybody else either way. That's the only thing that...
Look at what he does on the field.
That we know of, though.
Yeah, exactly.
That we know of. They don't say everything.
That we know of.
I'm sure they know more than
that. But then you
can
make an argument for literally every single person who's kicked off of everything.
Yeah, we don't know what goes on in the locker room on a daily basis.
Hey, I'll tell you the reason why.
You have the same issues with the national team.
Ludo.
Martinez is not calling him.
Ludo, you want to know the reasons why the guy was you know, Icardi was given the boot? Is the reason why
Gabagool.
The same way.
This is the because Icardi will be the first person to, or like Nainggolan to say to Conte, I say, listen, with all due respect, just do your job and let me do my job. You don't know what you're talking about. Stick with what you know what to do, and let me do what I know how to do, and that's it.
It's a really good transition because there's a quote
from
Allegri this week, which I really liked. And he said, in Italy, the tactics, the schemes, they're all bullshit. Football is art, and the artists are the world-class players. You don't have to teach them anything. You just admire them. He said, if the players are used to going through... He also gave a good example. He said, you know, some of these players that we're teaching right now, where we go too tactical in Italy, is if we all we do is just teach them, and we don't allow them to think on their
right.
own, when there's a door in front of them, they're going to run through the door instead of, oh, I can unlock the door and think on their own. And I think it's a little bit weird coming from Allegri, which I don't think that Allegri was a free guy at all with what he did with Dybala, which is funny, right. One thing. But I do agree that at a certain point, and I like what Guardiola had said, where 3/4 of the field, you listen to exactly what I'm telling you to do. But the last fourth, you guys are, like he said, the artist. You are the world-class players. You know what to do. Yeah. I don't need to teach you. You got to be on the left side this one. You don't got to be there.
And that's what
when
Conte,
you have certain players.
He's a control freak.
But,
that's a control but freak.
Conte,
to tell them, listen, the same loser of this guy here. What's
guys,
his name,
you know better
Sarri.
Than me.
Sarri, listen to me.
Defense with championship. Offense sells tickets.
Listen to me. Sarri is ruining Cristiano Ronaldo. Cristiano Ronaldo is a man into the box. You just have to feed the box into the box. With this Sarri, this guy here, he's coming. He's playing from the left side. He goes back to the midfield, picks up the ball.
How do you get into the box? You got to get into the box.
Cristiano Ronaldo belongs inside of the box.
I agree with that.
Okay?
With
that. And you think that every ball is going to touch the ball in the net?
Because of this imbecile of Sarri.
No. So what you're saying is just because you got Ronaldo in the box, he's going to get the ball, and the defenders are going to say, Mr. Ronaldo, please.
No, did you see how high he jumped?
But listen to me.
Okay.
Mr. Ronaldo.
There was another player that jumped higher than him back in the
70s. Listen to me. Ronaldo attracts a lot of attention.
What does that have to do with
Ronaldo
that?
Attracts a lot of attention into the box. When two or three people that are going to go on Ronaldo, there are going to be other people open. So all you have to do is just pass the people.
I don't agree. I don't agree. You know why? I'll tell you why I don't agree.
We're starting.
When Ronaldo... When Ronaldo plays outside the box, he still has that quick move to go towards the box. Remember, he dribbles in tight spaces. The ball is glued to his feet. And when he dribbles to the right or to the left, he releases those shots, hard shots that go like this, that dip down without taking the 2-3 steps behind. So meaning is, when he dribbles a little bit like this, he's able to shoot that quickness. But he has to start from outside the box, not be inside the box.
By starting from outside, he gets stressed out.
Ronaldo is not a player to play to the back of the keeper. Period.
Listen.
End of conversation.
He needs to play where he was playing last year.
He cannot play in the box to the back of the keeper. He cannot.
He's changing everyone's mentality over that's here.
I disagree with you. I just
the back of the keeper.
A lot of people are saying straight.
I don't think he needs to be the back of the keeper, but I think that he's.
But if you're in the box, what do you, how do you play?
When crosses are coming in.
Yeah, but he's saying the left, the right.
No, I don't like Ronaldo come from the left.
Baludo, when he wastes a lot of energy, he does. He's 34 years old, so he doesn't have the gas like he did back in the day.
Outside the box, he has that quick. But see, he's very good with the upper part of his body in faking the defenders. He can't. The ball is glued to his feet. And as soon as he moves those 6 inches to the right and he fakes the keeper, I mean, not the keeper, the defender, he's able to let those shots go or the passes go very quickly without extending his legs so much.
Listen, Ronaldo,
that's my analysis.
I didn't like Allegri as a coach for Juventus, but Ronaldo is like a ghost of himself seen playing under Sarri. It's just, it's
Juventus right now is half Sarri and half Allegri, period. Wow. But give it time. Now you got January, you got February, you got to concentrate on the Champions
League. There's a lot of good arguments. A lot of
the season is not over yet. We still let's enjoy the fish. Still let's enjoy early. Christmas, okay. New Year.
Let's enjoy the fish, guys. The Gabagool.
That video of you recreating that. Did you see? Did you see the video of Antonio recreated it. It was hilarious. By the way, everybody, there's some comments that people think that we hate each other. We're just passionate people. We all have different opinions.
Sometimes you want to punch each other in the head for the good
reason. Hey, it's like a family.
But
we're just passionate. Nobody's disrespecting anybody. Absolutely we're all friends off of this. It's on camera. When we talk about football, when we talk about culture, this is how it is, right?
The thing about football, everybody has their own opinion, and we respect other people's opinion. I see soccer in a certain way. Other people don't necessarily have to.
You pointed at Anto when you said that.
Yeah,
guys, for the records, when I'm wrong, I'm right. And when I'm right, I'm right. Okay?
I thought you were going to get tricked up over there. But it's like when we go play. I mean, I go harder on Michael than anything else. But we're friends. Sure. But listen, when you play your best. That's it. No friendships. Just the way it is. Just business.
That's right. At the end of the day, AC Milan is still alive. Don't worry about the 5-0, okay? Don't worry. It's just...
Yeah, this guy keeps... You see why he's waving?
It's like... It's
he's
all
saying right. Ciao to Serie B, right?
No, pretend, he's saying 5.
Pretend you didn't watch...
Oh, my God!
Pretend that you didn't watch the game. It's been a bad dream. You're going to wake up.
It's
you're
not a bad dream,
wash
though.
Your face. Everything is going to go away.
Christmas is coming.
And then you go back to
coming. Okay, Merry Christmas. Happy Holiday.
I can just imagine him this morning as soon as he wakes up. And he goes, pa, 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 3 smacks as soon as he woke up. 3-0, and then the other two when he went downstairs for COVID.
Let him have fun. Let him have fun. That's okay. I'm gonna be smacking him around when the next time that Napoli loses.
Napoli is 3 points now above Milan. They were tied at one point, right?
That's why I sat in that chair.
So now you separate. So now you separated yourselves from the herd.
That's why I sat in this chair.
Wow. That's true.
Yay! If you guys wind up losing next week, you're gonna be under the table.
2 weeks.
Home in the bathroom.
2 weeks.
Yeah. 2 weeks now. Okay. Now we play the Epiphany. We play on the 6th.
Good?
Okay.
Yeah. We're done? Okay? Yeah, we're done. All right, guys.
Guys.
As always, thank you for watching. We'll talk to you soon.
Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah.
Yeah, keep rating with 5 stars. Mm-hmm. Don't worry about if your girlfriend, kicked you out or you kicked your girlfriends out or whatever the problem might be. Keep starting because, it's very important.
Finals,
right?
No, finals are done.
Well, are they done?
Starting to get your book again refreshed for your spring session, right?
Uh-huh. Okay. So it's the end of January.
Okay, at the end of January. And if you are depressed, put the radio on, put Spotify, Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, LinkedIn. Microsoft, whatever. We always here for you guys. Don't be depressed. 5 stars, end of the story.
Merry Christmas. Thank you, Hanukkah.
That's what we talk to.
Let's go, baby. Forza
Sassuolo. Forza Sassuolo.
Who said that?
You said it. Oh.